We've talked about different coordinate systems, and now we're going to talk about moving around spaces with different basis vectors. So let's talk about choosing a reference point for locating an object in space. So here's our XY plane, and we are going to try to locate the star. So here we have a star, and we're going to use E1 and E2 as our way to locate that star. So if we're just moving in the XY plane, pretty easy, but now we have some obstacles in the way. So if we have the standard basis, these vectors E1 and E2 and E, it's difficult to create a path to that object with those basis vectors. But what if we take our two vectors that we're using to locate this object and we tilt them slightly? So we take them and we just shift them up, by a particular angle. Well, if we do that, it becomes much easier to find a clear path to our point of interest, so the star, using this new basis F that contains the vectors F1 and F2. So if we use a different reference, our basis, it can make state description a little bit more clear. That's going to be important for us in quantum computing. So as a review, we have all these different state vectors. And they have a vector notation associated with them. So here, if we have alpha and beta, so A and B associated with ket 0 and ket 1, we have the corresponding column vector. And then we have our superposition states and their corresponding column vectors as well. Typically, we use the computational basis. So the computational basis corresponds to ket 0 and ket 1, or the top of the Bloch sphere and the bottom of the Bloch sphere. So the computational basis that lies on the z-axis of the Bloch sphere, very important. We also have the Hadamard basis. So we use this in quantum informatics sometimes. And what it is, if we want to think about the Hadamard basis in terms of the computational basis, it is the superposition state and the superposition state with phase. So what does that mean? So we take our ket zero and shift it 90 degrees to put it on the x-axis to create ket plus, and then ket minus is created by taking the ket one state and shifting it by 90 degrees to place it on the x-axis as well. So this creates our superposition state with phase. So what does it mean to be a basis of a vector space? So a basis is a set of vectors that can be used to express any point in the vector space as a linear combination. So think about our quantum state, how we have our state as alpha ket zero plus beta ket one. Our state is a linear combination of ket zero and ket one. Well, we can also have linear combinations of other basis states. And sometimes it makes our problems easier to solve if we choose one basis over another. So if we're thinking about our XY plane example, we have our states E1 and E2, which are simply just a unit step on either the X or Y axis respectively. We can combine them in such a way that we can describe the points of interest in our space. So here, if we're looking at the vector W, which is 2, 3, that can be expressed as a linear combination of E1 and E2. So this is an example of how you would use a basis within your vector space. So let's discuss change of basis. Let's go between the computational basis and the Hadamard basis. We have a linear transformation, and don't let the word confuse you. This linear transformation, what does that mean? That's simply a matrix. So the matrix M that we have applies a linear transform that allows a base conversion. So we converge between computational basis and Hadamard basis. So we'll have MHC convert from computational basis to Hadamard. So think 2 Hadamard from HC, 2C to computational from Hadamard, for MCH being Hadamard to computational basis conversion. And we'll have a couple of aspects that we need to define for this transformation. So we need to make sure that MHC, or the transform from computational basis to Hadamard, is equal to the inverse of MCH, or the conversion from Hadamard to computational basis. And we can relate them in such a way that we end up getting the Hadamard operation. So we have H, which is from our reversibility lectures, we know is self-inverse, or is its own inverse. So we can use the Hadamard operation in order for us to move from the computational basis to the Hadamard basis. So let's map some coordinates, computation to Hadamard. So we have ket 0 moving to ket plus using the Hadamard transform. So we just multiply the vector associated with ket 0. And then we have ket 1 moving to ket minus, simply with another vector matrix multiplication, this time using the vector representation for ket 1. Now let's think about this. So true or false, the computational basis states of ket 0 and ket 1 lie on opposite sides of the Bloch sphere, but ket plus, ket minus do not. So the answers we have for this would be either A, true, B, false, C, sometimes true, D, I don't know. Here, the correct answer is false. So ket plus and ket minus are also always going to be on the opposite sides of the Bloch sphere, just this time on the x-axis. It's actually something that we have to take a note of, that using vectors located on the opposite sides of the Bloch sphere is really important if we're trying to define a new basis for our quantum system, because we have to respect this orthogonal aspect between those basis, those vectors in our basis. But that's something that we'll talk a little bit more about later on.